a machine commonly used for pain relief, has shown to improve breathing in patients with obstructive sleep apnea, a clinical trial has found. Results of the Tesla trial, published in the journal eClinical Medicine by researchers from King's College London and Guy's and St. Thomas's NHS Foundation Trust, shows the potential of a new therapeutic option for patients using a transcutaneous electrical stimulation, TENS machine. Sleep apnea affects about 1 billion people worldwide and millions in the UK. While the condition can be frequently associated with snoring, people who are affected stop breathing many times during the night. The condition leaves people excessively sleepy during the day, lacking attention, and sometimes experiencing headaches. People diagnosed with sleep apnea are advised not to drive when feeling excessively sleepy. Many people with sleep apnea may use a continuous positive airway pressure, CPAP machine, which pumps air into a mask you wear over your mouth or nose while you sleep. However, only about 75% of patients adhere to CPAP after 3 months, and after 5 years of treatment, this is down to about 25%. Evidence-based alternatives for CPAP are limited, but include a specialized mouth guard which pushes the lower jaw forward, known as a mandibular advancement devices, and in some cases, surgical options. The TENS machine used in the Tesla trial is a small battery-operated device that has leads connected to sticky pads called electrodes. It is commonly used to reduce pain from conditions such as arthritis and during child labor, but has not been used for people with obstructive sleep apnea before. The Tesla trial shows this can be a cheap and non-invasive treatment method. Patients with obstructive sleep apnea were randomized and said to receive a TENS machine or CPAP. The light and continuous electric stimulation of the TENS machine is enough to keep the airway open while sleep, allowing easy breathing to continue. Patients treated with TENS showed improvements in nocturnal breathing and a significant reduction of daytime exhaustion. The trial also shows that this treatment could be considered for patients who do not respond well to CPAP, providing a second-line treatment that is cheaper and less time-consuming to roll out than current alternatives.